everyone and welcome to our session. I hope that you all are fine and doing well at your home. So today we are going to start a new lesson, new session, new topic in our subject social science. Before starting, I thought why don't we start something new today, learn some new thing, a thought. Okay, the thought is very easy. Remember that I will ask you afterwards. So the thought is, a person without the knowledge of his history, past history, origin and culture is like a tree without roots. एक पर्सन जिसकी पास उसके हिस्ट्री उसका ओरिजिन या उसका कल्चर उसे नहीं पता, दैट मीन्स ही इज लाइक अ ट्री, इट इज लाइक अ ट्री जिसके रूट्स नहीं है. वेरी डीप थॉट. आई विल आस्क यू द मीनिंग, ट्राई टू रिकॉग्नाइज, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग. आप कोशिश करना. सो इस थॉट के वर्ड से यू केम टू नो दैट टूडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू लेसन विच विल बी फ्रॉम अवर हिस्ट्री. So why we are learning history? I am sure that you have understood. Let's move to our chapter. So as we have learned the thought, as we have learned the quote, that is very important for a person to know their roots. Now we will talk about our today's lesson. Lesson 6, administrative system and architecture during the medieval life. You know why I have explained you that thought? Because of this lesson. In this lesson, what we are going to learn? हम आज लेसन में हम क्या समझने वाले हैं? Let's see. First of all, we are going to learn about the administrative system. As you can clearly see, administrative system means how the work was done at that time, how the king was ruling at that time, how the people were working under the king. What type of rules they were following, what type of management was there, that is called administrative system. We are going to learn the administrative system during medieval age. Medieval age means when there were kings who were ruling on our country, India. Okay, next is literature. As you all know that our country is also full of many old literature, many old books and stories. So it is very important for us to know that the literature, the previous stories which are related to the mankind, which shows the culture of our country, we have to learn them. Okay, so in this chapter we will learn that literature. Next is architecture. Architecture, different many kinds of buildings, temples, that all the other buildings were built during the time when kings were ruling, that means during medieval age. So what was their importance in history? Why the king was very eager to build buildings, and why they were encouraging the people to write the things, to develop different kind of architecture, alag alag architectures kyun banwate the? Why the kings were very much involved in all this? What was the importance of all this in our history? So that we are going to learn in this lesson. So as before starting the lesson, before starting any lesson in history, there is a small story which is given in your textbook. Here is also one story, very small story, of a boy named Utsav. Do you want to hear? Okay, so let's start. There is a boy named Utsav. In his village, that means unke gaon mein, in his village there was a concert. In today's language it is called like a concert, but in earlier it was called as a lok dairo. Kasim means lok dairo. What is lok dairo? A group of folk singers. See, in earlier days in the villages there was like some people gather. They gathered in one big place. That place is called chowk in Hindi. In English you can say village square. In every village there is a place which is very big and it is used for conducting any meeting or to conduct any assembly, to gather the people and to inform them, to give them some notice or any information. Okay, So there also in the village, Kasid Meres Lokdar was organized, means a concert is there in which the people will sing and the other people will sit and listen and listen to the songs. So what happened with when it was told that today it is going to be organized in the village? So first of all, who are excited? Children, small children are very excited to attend these concerts or to attend any kind of event which are there conducted in village. So the small children came running and started taking their place in the front row. सबसे पहले आके आगे पहली row में the small children came and they have seated. Okay. So next is the now the concert is started. Now what happened in the folk songs? Means the concert was of folk songs. Folk songs का concert था. That means the songs which are sung in every occasion, in every festival, local people sings that song. Okay, it is according to their culture. But in between that folk songs, the patriotic songs also were sung. Patriotic songs. What are the patriotic songs? Deshbhakti Geet in Hindi. Okay, the songs which are sung for our nation, for our country, for our mother India. Okay, so unke gaane bhi shuru ho gaye. Next is when it was done, Utsav was very excited. He was very happy. There was a palya recital. The meaning of this palya recital is that these are some kind of songs which are sung as a tribute to the persons who die in the battlefield or who die doing some kind of welfare of the people. Okay, in some कुछ भलाई करने के लिए वो कुछ करते हैं. At that time if they die, उनके लिए these songs are sung. In the village there is every song for every occasion. बहुत सारे songs होते हैं अलग अलग for every occasion. Okay, so now I hope you understood this. Once again you will see there is a boy named Utsav in his village. There is a concert which is organized. इसको कहा जाता है कि language में लोकदारों मेरी कासिम मेरी लोकदारों कासिम मेरी is a name. The group of a people came and they will sing the songs and the other people they will sit and listen. It is organized in village square, that means chowk, जो village का बीच का जो portion होता है वहाँ पे. Now, in between these folk songs, patriotic songs started and Utsav got very excited. Palya recital, matlab the songs which are sung as a homage, as a tribute for the people who died in protecting our country and doing any welfare for the country or for the people. Okay, so what happened next? Palya, what is the meaning of Palya? Palya recital means the songs. Palya means a memorial commemorating the heroes. It is a type of a stone. In many villages or in many areas of our country, there is a stone which is done, means just stone ko lagaya jata hai, because as a memory for the people who did something good for our country or for our nation, for the people of our country. Okay, so Palya is a type of a memorial commemorating the heroes. For example, if there is a word hero, you might have seen many heroes. We have seen many heroes in the movies, and many heroes are like they do the good for the people. For example, someone is there who is saving the life of old person. He saved him from accident. Accident se kisi ko bachaya. So he is a type of a hero. तो ऐसे ही लोगों की याद में there is a stone, एक stone लगाया जाता है, and also in the villages that stone is worshipped, उसकी पूजा की जाती है. It is worshipped when there is any festival, when there is any event in the village. तो तब many people come and worship that stone as we worship the god. So this is the meaning of Palya. Now it is generally in simple sentence we can say that it is a tribute to martyrs. मतलब जो हमारे battlefield में हमारे border पे जो शहीद हो जाते हैं, it is just a tribute उनकी याद में हम ये करते हैं. Many things are there. बिकॉज ऑफ विच उनकी जो मेमोरी है हमारे दिमाग में रह जाती है, हमारे माइंड में रह जाती है. नाउ ओके आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट दिस पाली आजा वर्शिप डेज इन फेस्टिवल्स एंड नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड उत्सव इज उत्सव इज गोइंग टू हिज होम. नाउ इन द मॉर्निंग व्हेन ही गेट्स अप द थिंग इज देयर इज अ थिंग इन हिज माइंड अबाउट दैट यस्टरडेज कॉन्सर्ट, कि कल जो कॉन्सर्ट था वो क्या था. सो ही डायरेक्टली गोज टू हिज ग्रैंडफादर एंड आस्क्ड हिज ग्रैंडफादर एवरीथिंग अबाउट पालिया, व्हाट इज पालिया एंड व्हाट इज ऑल दीज थिंग्स. ग्रैंडफादर एक्सप्लेन्ड हिम एवरीथिंग. नाउ द वेन उत्सव एंड हिज फ्रेंड्स टोल्ड हिज ग्रैंडफादर टू इनलाइटन अस अबाउट द कल्चर ऑफ अवर कंट्री, मतलब उन्होंने अपने ग्रैंडफादर को बोला दैट प्लीज ग्रैंडपा tell us more about our culture, about our country, tell us more stories, what happened actually. So his grandfather told wait, his grandfather went in the room and went inside and brought some photos. For example, he brought the photos of for example any monument, for example Taj Mahal. Okay, so photos he got and the grandfather shows them. And the Utsav and his friend got very excited to know about what these photos are. So his grandfather told them that now if you want to hear the story, if you want to hear about our culture, I will start with the civilization and culture of Rajput age. Unke grandpa kehte hai ki agar aapko story suni hai to main Rajput age se start karta hu. That means what type of कल्चर वॉज देयर एंड राजपूत किंग्स वर देयर, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सिविलाइजेशन, क्या संस्कृति थी, क्या हमारे रीति रिवाज थे जिनको वो फॉलो करते थे, ऑल दैट थिंग्स व्हिच वाज देयर इन द राजपूत एज व्हेन देयर वर राजपूत किंग्स, वो मैं आपको बताता हूँ. सो ही बिगिन द स्टोरी एंड नाउ वी विल ऑल्सो लर्न द रेस्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी इन द लेसन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई थिंक दैट दिस ऑल इज क्लियर. नाउ grandfather will tell the stories of administrative literature, administrative system, literature and one more thing, architecture, and this whole we will also learn with them. So let's begin the next topic. So to begin with the topic administrative system during the Rajput age, earlier India was not ruled over by one king. India was not ruled over by single king. There were many kings which were ruling. So that is why we can say that India was divided into many big and small parts. The extent of the parts, the areas which the king has covered, that totally depends on king's military prowess. Iska matlab kya hota hai? That means the part, the area which one king is having, or if he is conquering the other area, that is dependent totally on his skill, military. उसकी skill कितनी है, king के पास कितनी शक्ति है कि वो कितनी area को conquer करके rule कर सकता है, it totally depends on him. That is why we can say that there were many different administrative system which were there in different parts of our country, and that is why we will learn each part. Okay, so what we have learned, India was not ruled over by one king. India, ek king ruling kiya tha. There were many kings and the many kings were ruling on different parts. We can say that the whole of India was divided into many big and small states. But the area which the king has covered or has conquered, it totally depends on his skill. Uske military power, uski army pe depend karta. That is why there is very vast difference between the administrative system of one between two areas. बहुत सारा difference हमें देखने को मिलता है. In the earlier lesson number 4, Rajput age, we have already learned about the different dynasties and उनकी थोड़ी थोड़ी stories, kings का name we all know. Now with that, this chapter we will continue. You can again say that our whole history is totally related with each other. So we will cover the next administrative system topic in the next session. Now, till then, remember what I have said in this video try to watch it again and remember the meanings of the word. Palya and Lok Dayalo, you have to remember that. Till then, stay safe, stay home, and thank you.